Evacuating people from a hostile foreign country requires a great deal of support and coordination. Task Force Yukon, comprised primarily of soldiers of the 4th Infantry Brigade Combat Team Airborne, 25th Infantry Division, and 5th Special Forces Group Airborne, are the answer to a notional request for security by the U.S. State Department, the United Nations, and other federal agencies during a training exercise at the Joint Readiness Training Center in Fort Polk, Louisiana.
The Special Operations Forces may be working very closely with the host nation forces and the government officials. People that are moving from villages or may be aware that in those villages the host nation forces have lost control or are being subject to influence from bad actors. And the Special Operations guys, you know, very small elements, don't have the ability to directly influence that, but they can work with the brigade counterparts who do have more significant forces and resources that they can bring to solve that problem set.
Displaced citizens begin arriving to the emergency evacuation center either on their own accord or with the help of the Green Berets.
What they'll do is they'll come in and they'll get a cursory screening at the marshalling area, bags checked, they'll get a metal wand wanted down to make sure there's no weapons or anything that could cause harm to anyone else in the evacuation process. Once they're cleared by medical, they'll get pushed up to the third floor to the comfort suite where they're just waiting for manifests and for the air flight to come in to get evac'd out of here.
Relief arrives for the displaced victims in the form of a C-130 led by the airmen of the 19th Airlift Wing from Little Rock Air Force Base. But the victory of a successful evacuation mission is short-lived as they head back to the city where the battle rages on. Reporting for the 20th Public Affairs Detachment at the Joint Readiness Training Center in Fort Polk, Louisiana, I'm Army Sergeant Kimberly Cooper-Williams.